Well, everything is quiet this Monday over there at District 3 Stadium in Rock Hill. 3 days ago, though, it was a much different story during the first ever WRHI Football City USA kickoff when three of the city's high schools face top-ranked football teams. Football might certainly fill the stands, but district officials say football is not a cash cow, as many may think. So where does the money come from to fund football and other athletic programs year-round? CN2's Alexandria Savage with the winning play.
Football season is here and fans are ready.
We probably have the most talent in this little area. A lot of will and determination from these young men out here.
However, over the years, budget cuts to athletic programs have put more pressure on booster clubs to fill the financial gap to support these teams.
We rely heavily on our booster clubs to help us operate. And by operating, I mean putting our teams on the road, paying for travel, paying for officials, paying for security.
We need to raise funds so we can have adequate equipment, uniforms. There's just a big expense to run all our sports here.
And multiple schools' booster clubs are working together in this football game to make a profit, which will be split three ways.
Concession sales, merchandise sales is a big part of why we come to these football games, not only to support our athletes and our teams, but also to raise money for our athletics.
This year's a little different because for the first time ever, all three high schools' booster clubs teamed up to buy, cook, and man the concession areas. In the past, each booster club worked separately, but they say teaming up reminds everyone we're all on the same team.
South Point's addition to concession sales is smoking thanks to the booster club's best-selling product.
We've been doing the turkey legs about 6 years now. We cook about 160 every Friday night, and then we sell out within the first or second quarter of each game.
Each high school has their products that sell, ensuring that booster club and football will continue to flourish.
Unfortunately, once upon a time, our booster clubs were used to enhance our athletic departments. Now we simply couldn't operate without them.
Luckily for athletes, boosters will continue to raise funds, and Football USA is ready to support them. In Rock Hill, Alexandria Savage, CN2 News.
Well, booster clubs are open to current parents of students, alumni, parents of alumni, as well as fans. If you're interested in joining a booster club, just contact the athletic department at the school you wish to join.